You're trying to tell us what a male and a female is. There is enough variance there to suggest that we don't really know.
Now, Alex, what you've done there, twice I've asked you a question. Like, let's be fair to each other. Please.
My answer is I don't know.
Alex, please. Alex.
Well, you know.
Now, listen to me. You've asked me about 5 or 6 questions, yeah? And I've answered them very directly. Yeah, no problem. Now, I'm asking you just 1 or 2. And what I want from you is you to really consider what you're saying. The first thing you said was that I don't feel comfortable, exactly what, I don't feel comfortable with this. What that constitutes in philosophy is exactly an aesthetic value judgment. So in other words, because you see something and it's distasteful for you, wait, hold on, please, that you're now willing to sideline it or invalidate it. Okay. Now, this is fallacious reasoning. What I'm asking you is, have you got any, wait, hold on, before you continue, because you have to allow one question to be asked, then you can answer it. What I'm asking you is there any way you can, using your reasoning, show us how the precepts, the concepts, the descriptions of heaven as per the Quranic narrative is logically invalid? Can you do it?
Well, I have a problem.
Can you do it first?
The fact that I should, when it suits you, or when it... In certain circumstances, I should recognize my moral, ethical qualities. And then in some instances, I should completely ignore them because their scripture is, you know, what we know, and we don't have the capacity to actually appreciate it. So we have to complete logic to the point that
you haven't answered my question.
So going back to what you say, I'll give you an example. I'll give you a very simple example. And you said yourself, we're going to be tweaked as we enter heaven to accept what it is for what it is.
I don't know what you're saying.
When we go to heaven, when we have these like 70 virgins,
72, according 72. To the hadith in Timothy, 72. Which some muhaddithin have said is weak, but majority say it's strong. Go ahead.
You said they have soul, you said they are as like us as we are, but they don't have a free will except us.
No, I didn't say this.
Let me ask you another thing.
No, hold on.
Let me ask you another thing.
No, because you just said something I didn't say.
Okay, that's not what you said. That's fine.
Yeah.
Let's say I go to heaven, another female, Muslim female, goes to heaven. Yeah. Is she going to be one of those 72?
No.
Why is there this?
Because no. She. No, hold on. That's different. Hold on. You asked a question.
Okay, good.
If you want to ask a question, you have to wait for the response. The Hurul Ayn described in the Quran, which are the virgins or whatever you want to call them, really, it's women. And the discussion's always been about women. But let me tell you something you didn't know. Let me tell you, I'm pretty sure you don't know this.
Yeah, what do women get in heaven?
Let me tell you something, something interesting.
Why you know everything?
Pardon?
Why you know everything?
I don't know everything. Let me ask you a question, because here you've talked about وَحُورٌ عَيْنٌ as the Quran says, but what you haven't talked about is وَغِلْمَانٌ. The Quran also talks about servant boys that will be created for the pleasure of women and men. Now, what you've done is you've ignored that strategically, either out of ignorance or out of...
There'll be a voice.
No problem. Now I'm telling you.
There'll be a voice for pleasure.
So if the question is, if your question was, why is it the case that men have servitude of a new creation of women, yeah, that are designed explicitly and exclusively for them, then the answer is that's not the case, because actually women and men also get these ghilman, who are servant boys, who will serve them in a similar capacity as with the hur, the men. So the point here is actually based on ignorant premise. Taking a step back from the so-called equality discussion that you've tried to put forward.
So even in heaven, there will continue to remain differences and not this kind of perfection where we are all the same. There's going to be females and males. We're going to have to feel these differences, right? We're going to continue to have to free will.
There will be differences, yes.
So if they If these differences continue to exist, surely at some point there's going to be a conflict.
Listen to me carefully. Listen to me carefully.
There's no conflict in heaven, mate.
Yes, thank you.
Isn't there? It doesn't happen.
Exactly.
No one argues. They argue in speaker's corner, that's it.
Alex, listen to me carefully. Why is there, how do you know, here's my question. How do you know that such a concept as conflict exists?
In heaven?
Here.
Well, talk about...
We saw it on your video.
No, hold on, one person at a time.
How do I know? I'll give you an example, right? You know, men, when it comes to like females, they compete. When it comes to resources, jobs, they compete.
Okay.
There is only one for one, unless...
How do you define conflict?
Well, there is like a, you know, a friction where you get to a point where there is a certain resource, like a bit of land. You want to protect your family.
Disagreement.
A tree with apples.
No problem.
It does come to resources.
Okay.
However,
not always. But ideas.
In some cases, it could be an abstract idea. It could be like a philosophy. It could be a conflict in ideology.
Excellent. Do you know Plato? He was the first major philosopher that I know of that he referred to a concept of universals. Universals. Now, what are universals? Universals are usually, in language, they're abstract nouns and or any noun, a common noun, yeah? Now, let me tell you what I mean by that. If I say white, white. What is white? It's something which shares a common characteristic, isn't it? So for example, if I grab a pearl and put it into my hand and I ask you to describe the color of the pearl, you'll say it's a white pearl. Likewise, if I point to a cloud, and it's not necessarily a very heavy cloud, and I ask you to describe the color of that cloud, you'll say it's white. Thus, the pearl and the cloud have something in common. This is what Plato referred to as universals. We know, I asked you about what is conflict. You said conflict is when you have disagreement, whether it be on resources or abstract ideas, etc. Why? Because you have been able to identify a common characteristic between different things, entities which exist in isolation. And you've been able to call that thing, which is a universal,
yes,
conflict, which is in English language a common noun. Now let me tell you something, educate you something. Did you know that Plato, the same philosopher that really understood this idea of universals, which he referred to as ideals, or he made the land or mode of forms, he also outlined the fact that those universals are in fact metaphysical in nature. Wait a minute, what do you mean by that?
I'll tell him.
Sorry. I have to tell the guy what I mean by that. I'll tell you what I mean by that. Let me tell you what I mean by that. If it's metaphysical in nature, it does not exist in the real world. Thus, white or triangle or whatever it is, an idea, that does not exist tangibly in the real world. Thus, if I were to ask an empiricist to tell me or to show me white, all they could do is show me multiple things tangibly which share the same characteristic of the color white. Thus, the example I aforementioned. Now, why is it ironic that you have here come forward and tell me that, look, conflict doesn't exist in heaven? It's because you've extrapolated a concept of conflict as per the universe in which you live in and the experiences in which you had and the commonalities or the thread you've been able to put with all the things which you consider as conflict, and you've superimposed that on another metaphysical thing which doesn't...
Why should it be when it comes to your heaven, it's so extremely exaggerated to be...
Are you understanding?
When it's about sex,
so the point is,
drinks,
when you're using...
When it comes to a conflict, suddenly we have to...
When we use common noun, this is what Ibn Abbas said. Ibn Abbas said, the only thing which is similar between that which is in heaven and that which is in this world is the name. Therefore, when you bring a concept like conflict, which is, as we said, a universal, and you try and superimpose it on heaven, which is a metaphysical concept, construct, which no one has seen except for what we say the prophets, Muhammad in particular, etc., then what you're doing is you're applying a fallacy of some sort, because really and truly,
it's a fallacy, man.
It's of course
you're
a fallacy.
When it comes to our motivations for going to heaven, all the benefits or whatever you get in heaven is so earthly and it's so like consistent with what makes us happy. Right?
As I said to you
like
before,
sex and money and drinks.
So
and meals, right?
What? But, so what?
Yeah, so what?
So what? Right.
Let's say so what. It doesn't matter. But
so how does that invalidate?
When it comes to the fact that we may have some idea of a conflict, you say no. That's just some sort of
I'm telling you, the idea of conflict, you've extrapolated from the world.
I'm saying if we continue to have free will.
I don't think you understand. I want to try and break it down. It's my fault that you don't understand. It's not your fault. Our ideas that we understand. If I say the word love, yeah? Give me any abstract noun. Give me any abstract noun. Hate, love. Give me another abstract noun. Anything you like, yeah? Disagreement, happiness, whatever. Okay. All of that which we can understand, all of that which these words can necessarily denote or connote, must explicitly relate to my experience or your experience? Yes or no? Okay. The Prophet told us explicitly that heaven, ما خطر على قلب بشر. No one has experience of this place. Now, there are exceptions, like we said, Muhammad, etc. But generally, no one has experience. Now, the point is, if you haven't got experience of heaven, to speculate about the minutiae of the what happens, the details, is neither here nor there. It doesn't mean anything for me. Do you understand what I'm saying?
So if you're saying...
My idea of desire would be different.
Okay, therefore, we can conclude the fact that we are incapable of having any understanding of heaven.
No, I didn't say any understanding. See, that's a straw man.
Speaker, when you look into it, that's what it comes to.
Because, Alex, what I'm saying is...
We first begin with the premise that actually heaven is cool. You can have all these pleasures. And then suddenly it seems all earthly, pleasures. But then you